and he said it that way. Now I'm so fucking cute.
Yeah.
He said, fuck you hoes,
right,
man.
Yeah, right. And you know, the other one said it too, Biggie. He didn't really give two shits about you goddamn black woman. And then it's big, to show you women, like the elder said, to show you women are phony, Biggie was an ugly, big, fat, cock-eyed, ugly nigga like him.
Right, right.
And they're all kind of, oh, Biggie, oh, my goodness, oh. He was popping all kind of women. Right. Women are fucking phony. They go with whoever got the power. That's why they with Esau.
That's right.
Because Esau, this so-called white man, got the power. But you know what, the scripture that the brother's reading, and like this brother, the elder said, man, when y'all start going down, man, in them camps, and start starving, and you ain't got no money for your accessories, your makeup, goodies, and the hair, and the shoes, and all that shit, and you ain't gonna be going to the clubs, you're gonna be starving, man.
Yep, right.
Y'all all gonna get skinny. See how the black woman's all fat
now.
Yeah,
all obese.
Yeah, but you know what? Lose weight.
The concentration camps, they got a diet plan for you black bitches, man.
Yeah.
You're gonna be skinny. You're gonna be able to hula hoop with a Cheerio.
And now this brother said 200,000 miles on that on a black woman's so-so. You know.
Yeah.
But anyway, I'll say it like that, brother. I curse too much any damn way. But anyway, you know this bitch that be on The View. I think her first name is Sherry or something like that.
That chubby bitch.
Yeah, the chubby bitch. Now there was an article somebody sent to me like 6 months ago, and she came out and confessed. I don't know if she wrote a book or whatever. But she said she had about 150 abortions, man. She said every night she was with a different man. But now all of a sudden, the hoe is a damn Christian.
Yeah.
She's dead on the inside, man. But now she's trying to be, now she's a Christian now, man. You black women are real fucking sluts, man. You have a low self-esteem, and you figure the way for you to get a good feeling is to have sex with anybody that you run into, and you figure that guy's gonna stay with you and you're gonna have that love, and then the guy love love is a real word. Then all of a sudden the guy don't want to deal with you no more because you're fucked up in the head,
right,
so you get with another guy and you do the same thing over and over again, like that next guy's gonna be the special guy, but the black man already woke up to your ass.
They already know
you're a fucking hoe and you're a piece of pussy. That's how they look at your ass, man.
That's right. Too many mouths, baby. Too many mouths.
Let me tell you, stupid hoes, one thing. All you for you women out there that's watching this, you got a man or some Jake you dealing with, just know he got other pussy on the side.
And you better deal with it. You better let it happen. Don't have a problem with it. Don't argue with your man, because he can cut you off.
Yep.
You know?
That's right.
Your men, they got other women. I hope y'all know that. Them Jake.
If he don't, he ain't a real man.
If he don't, he's a faggot. Right. But most of these Jakes, especially if he's one of them hip, cool, good-looking chicks, just know he got a hoes, he popping. You in that rotation, man. You a part of a rotation. Okay, he gets with you, and he's with you, and then when he leaves you, he got other women. Because it's in the so-called black man's spirit, and the Latino man, it's in their spirit.
Yeah, because you know what? Women roll up on these men at jobs and in the mall and different places. So if the woman look good and she throws herself in the guy's face, it's only part of the black man's manhood to get that number. Because he'll be less of a man.
Yeah.
That's part of the challenge, right?
It's duty. Yeah.
That's his duty.
Duty to please that duty.
That's right, man. So all you black women that's dealing with these so-called black men, and you Latino women that's dealing with these Latino men, just know that they got other
Salakia.
Just know that they got other women on the side.
Just know when the Lord raises up, we're going to have other women on the side.
Well, that's going to be
the problem. They got a problem with that scripture in Isaiah, the 4th chapter.
Yeah, right.
You know, man, the kingdom, they doing it, we already doing it.
Exactly.
And you know what? There's nothing wrong with what we're doing.
Right.
But
right.
If you do it, you're a hoe. That's why we call you a hoe.
Right.
That's why there's a song out there that goes, use a hoe. Use a hoe.
That's it.
Hey, Ludacris, all kind of rappers put why you think they put lyrics dissing you like that? Because rap is all about their personal experiences.
Right.
So they ain't making it up.
Right.
It's all true. They wouldn't say it if it wasn't true.
Yeah. Hey, well, you black women, you know that you hoes, because you call each other hoes. What that hoe talking about?
Right?
So you already, so you black women, you already know that you're hoes.
That's how they talk to each other.
That's how you talk to each other. I kick that hoe's ass, and she come up in my face. I beat that hoe's ass. I beat that bitch ass. That's how you talk, man. You know, nobody in their right mind want to be around your nigga woman, man. There's a scripture where it says, I'd rather dwell with a lion.
Yeah.
You know, you can get that. Hey, he's talking about the black woman.
You're an anachronism. you're a bug. You're a ghost from another time. you are obsolete.
And we ain't just saying that, man. You got brothers back here. We don't deal with black women, all right?
You are.
All right? We'll deal with the other women of the other nations. Not you black bitches, man. As far as we're concerned, they could take you and put you on an island and nuke that island.
Ecclesiastes.
Then we're
going to
go back to
Tazatakia said that the black woman got a heavy manly spirit on her.
Yeah.
And I mean, I remember being in high school, it was nothing to see one black bitch say to another, suck my dick, bitch.
Yeah.
Like, what kind of shit is that? Yeah. So that's supposed to be attractive? You know what?
Yeah. And then you got these punk ass black men talking. That's my queen.
Yeah.
My queen.
Hey, you guys from 14th Street, man. Just take off them garments and go back in the world. Yeah. Cause you niggas ain't right, all right?
Well, they're not in the truth anyway. They're not in the truth.
And then you had one guy in 14th Street. He was speaking to the cracker like he wanted to take the cracker out on a date. You know, he's all being all nice to the cracker. Hey, you guys ain't got the spirit, man. You ain't men of the Lord.
Stop perpetrating the fraud. This is Ecclesiastes 25 and 16. I had rather dwell with a lion and a dragon than to keep house with a wicked woman.
And you know he was talking about the nigger woman.
Right.
All right?
You had something, brother?
Bring on what you got.
Isaiah 3 and 16. Moreover, the Lord saith, because the daughters of Zion are haughty and walk with stretched forth necks and wanton ass, walking.
Read it again.
Isaiah 3 and 16.
Go on.
Moreover, the Lord saith, because the daughters of Zion.
Right, now that's talking about the black woman. Daughters. When you see the word daughters, that's talking about the women. When you see daughter of Zion, that's talking about the men, Israelite men. Daughters of Zion is talking about the so-called black woman. Go on.
Daughters of Zion.
Go on. Because she's the daughter of Zion.
Are haughty.
Go on.
And walk with stretched forth necks.
Right, they're haughty, meaning proud. When you look up that word haughty, it means proud. But proud with a mean demeanor. Yeah. Like the way they look at you, like you're shit, like you're horse shit.
Like,
right?
Like then when we were looking at that brother that was interviewing
in that video.
In the video.
Exactly.
He was just trying to ask him a simple question. They were like.
Right. Right. Yep. That's an example of being haughty. Go on.
And wanton ass.
Right. Haughty and wanton. Now the word wanton means undisciplined. Right. You be with them. Like you have a black woman. She'll be riding, like they say, riding shotgun. She's riding in the passenger side. And every time the car stops at the light, the traffic light, she's looking at the guy in the next car. That's disrespectful to you. Right. What the fuck is she looking for in that car? Did she leave something in there?
Maybe.
So why is she looking in that car?
She probably did leave something.
She probably did leave, yeah. But that's disrespectful, man.
Yeah. Walking and mincing as they go.
So that's the Lord describing the so-called black woman. Walking and mincing as she go. She be switching. And like the elder Aria used to say years ago, she wears those shoes clip clop, making that noise. Yeah, he said that. Go on.
And making a twinkling with their feet.
Right, making a tinkling with their feet. Tinkling. Hey, brother. Tinkling with their feet.
Making a tinkling with their feet.
Go on.
Therefore, the Lord will smite with a scab the crown of the head of the daughters of Zion.
That's why the black woman's hair is so short. Because that's a curse from the Lord for her being haughty and for her being a whore.
That's right.
The Lord said, read that part again. I will scab.
Therefore, the Lord will smite with a scab.
Take. Go on.
With a scab.
Give her a scab head. That's what they call it down south, scab heads.
Scab head.
Right. That's where she bears, because a woman, it tells you in 1 Corinthians, a woman's hair is her glory.
Right.
So that shows you right there that the so-called black woman, her glory has been taken from her because of her attitude towards her man.
Mad, boy.
All right? Go on.
With they scab, the crown of the head of the daughters of Zion.
Right, because what's the crown of a woman? Her hair. Hold that. Let's prove that in 1 Corinthians.
Yeah. And that Pula nigga woman is the most cursed out of all the other tribes.
Exactly.
Because y'all ain't got no hair. That's why the black woman.
The nigga woman, the Benjamite woman.
The West